So here I am, everyone. We are launching Amazing Spider-Man. This is one of the games that eluded me when it launched, but one of my friends played it and said it was really good, and I love Spider-Man, personally. Like, always been a big fan since I was a kid. I have a box still today, like a wooden wine crate filled with all these really cool, like, Spider-Man action figures and stuff. So I'm pretty excited. I played all the older 360 Spider-Man games, like Web of Shadows and stuff, and I know that was really cool. Not a very fun, like, game. It was kind of stupid, but cool game, though.
Progress. Nature to man. Man to machine. The path to our future. Oscorp. The Oscorp of today is evolving, and innovative technology needs a guiding hand. Under the direction of Dr. Alistair Smythe, the betterment and security of human life has become our one goal. His mastery of nanotechnology and macro-robotics will guide Oscorp Industries to a better and brighter tomorrow.
Nanobots, what are they? Imagine a robot. Now imagine 400 of them, standing on a dime. A microscopic army working on a molecular level. Their size is their strength.
The robots are
and
really
their potential
fine,
is limitless.
The leadership of Dr. Alistair Smythe will usher in a new era,
like little astronaut guys,
for Oscorp and mankind.
Oscorp, a new company with the name you trust.
Like Bandai or Apple. Nice commercial there, Oscorp. Take photos of the Spider-Man logo throughout Manhattan to unlock surprises. Okay. This is weird. Why is it gray? Shouldn't it be white? When it's gray, it almost looks like it's, like, not available, but it's a weird UI thing. Let's just check the achievements real fast for this game. Oh, okay. We have to beat it on Superhero. We'll just... Oh! That's so many! Let's hope those are like every 3 feet. I hope Bruce Campbell's still the narrator of this game. He's like the narrator in all the old like PS1 Spider-Man games, and it was really weird. I don't know why that was who they chose, but it was super awesome. Defeat 1,000 enemies. All right. Okay. Yeah. All right. Superhero. Oh god, that sounds terrible. Why would I want the map to rotate with me? Probably gonna change its aesthetic, but we'll see what it looks like. In theory, it sounds awful. Go. The hell? Why can't I control? I think the game bugged out. Are you serious? Okay, I guess we're relaunching. That was stupid. Alright, here we are again. Now the menus work. So here we go. superhero.
Peter, what are you doing here?
I'm here to get you out of this asylum.
But you put me here, and with good reason. I can't...
I know, it's crazy. But time's running out, Connors. Something bad has happened. Something really bad.
They have such a generic, like, dub anime voice for Peter in this game. Oh, okay, so this takes place after the first movie, and it's bringing in Smythe to take over Oscorp, which is fine. That all makes sense. It's, like, practical.
Progress.
Hey there.
Hey.
Thanks for coming with me, Pete. You're brave. We're gonna have to be careful here. Supposed to be here after hours.
I hope it's better than the first time I snuck in. That was not fun.
We're not sneaking. We're investigating. Weird things happen here after hours. Stuff that Dr. Smythe's trying to get rid of. He's not a bad guy, you know? He wants to turn this company around.
Yeah, that's what the video said. So, what exactly is rotten in the state of Oscorp?
I think they're continuing Dr. Connor's work. Cross-species experiments. Come on.
Whoa now. Like, making more lizards?
Making more everything. I'm not sure, but we're gonna find out tonight. Oscorp has the geniuses and the resources. Why can't it be a benefit to people? That's why I came back. And Dr. Smythe wants to change things.
I know. His brilliant research will usher in a new era for all humanity.
I'm Peter Parker, the Cynic.
Okay, just wait a second.
To our future.
Well, we're definitely safe out here, because we'll never get in.
We're in. Huh. Keep your head down.
Real stealthy.
Wow. Look at all this. I knew Dr. Smythe was the nanobot guy, but I had no idea he had big bots, too. I can't believe you get to play with this stuff every day.
It never gets old.
She needs to stop crouch walking. This looks ridiculous. We look more noticeable than ever.
Oh my god. This could be proof they're continuing Connor's work.
Is that supposed to be Rhino?
How can he still move like
that? Come on.
I'm sorry. I gave him everything we had. Is everyone okay? Gwen? Are you all right?
Yeah, thanks, Dr. Smythe.
Hey, you kids are in big trouble. What are you doing here?
It's okay, it's okay. They're with me. What are you doing here, Gwen? You know you're not supposed to be here after hours. Especially with a guest.
Dr. Smythe, I am so, so sorry. This is my friend, Peter Parker.
Peter Parker? I've heard about you.
I'm hearing a lot about you tonight.
So, why are you here?
I'm totally to blame, Doc. I'm amazed at what you've done with Oscorp. When I heard about the changes you were making, you know, nanobots, I wanted to see them for myself.
You worked with Connors, right? Funny finding you here now as I waste my time trying to dispose of these cross-species.
So this is a cross-species? You promised me that all of Connors' work was over. How many more do we keep here?
I told you the truth, Gwen. The experiments have stopped, just not as early as I'd hoped. No more humans turning into animals like Connors did. But what you see here is what happens when an animal gets a nice dose of human DNA. Here, follow me. I trust you'll keep everything you see in the strictest confidence.
This isn't humans turning into animals, it's animals turning into humans, okay? Shut up, Gwen.
An
another one of these cross species?
This is crazy. The lizard almost destroyed the city. What rational mind would continue to create these things?
Changing the ethics of a large corporation takes time. Now, some scientists argue that these pathetic creatures have some benefit. But they lost that argument. As of tonight, these cross species disappear. We're shipping them to our biolab for safe disposal. Out of sight, out of mind.
Has this thing eaten today?
It always looks like that. They went farther with Connor's work than we realized. The species in this room are incredibly dangerous, highly contagious.
Hey, where'd he go? Come on out, little fella.
That little fella is a walking disease. Any direct contact with it leads to infection. Infection leads to death, or becoming a cross species yourself. I want to keep you human, Parker. Let's keep moving.
Is there a cure?
Well, for these things, no. They were never human to begin with. They were born in a petri dish. For the poor humans it infects, unfortunately not. Attempts to develop an antidote have been unsuccessful. I don't want to seem cruel, but you have to understand, that thing is pure vermin. Creatures like this brought Europe to its knees with the plague.
Yeah, the old rat plague.
Well, I don't think he likes me.
That's strange. It only reacts like that when it's around other... I mean...
other handsome guys like me? I'm used to it.
Unlike robots, biological creatures are unpredictable.
Nice one,
Gwen. I much prefer things I can control.
Unpredictable, huh? What is that? An iguana? This has to be the strangest office tour I've ever been on.
Don't worry, Parker. Our next stop is the nanobot lab. Once you see it, you won't want to leave.
Hey, excuse me, Dr. Smythe. I need someone with special clearance to help me take this down to B sector.
Oh, I don't have time for this. Gwen, maybe it's a good thing you're here. You can deal with some of this bureaucratic nonsense. A punishment for trespassing. Go with him and catch up with us when you're done.
Doctor, I think I'll escort her. You know, make sure she doesn't get eaten.
I understand. The beast is as enthralled by beauty as man is. Meet me in the lab when you're done. And don't wander. It's an order, Miss Stacy.
Sure, Dr. Smythe. But don't... Come on, Pete.
Great meeting you, Doctor.
Likewise, Barbara.
It looks like alien.
You gotta be kidding me. That's taking things a little far, isn't it?
It's a terrible legacy. But Dr. Smythe says we're putting it in the past. I believe him.
What the what?
Oh,
what
did you do to it?
I didn't do anything.
Peter, I think it senses your blood. It knows.
It's clearly reacting to something. I've never... Oh my god! It's breaking the glass!
Smythe, I shouldn't have brought you here.
I can help.
Me?
Dr. Smythe, something is wrong. He's breaking out.
They're all breaking.
I'll sign a waiver later. I can help.
Sorry, Kent. We gotta clear this area.
I'm not leaving you.
Dr. Connor started this, and I want to finish it on my terms. Peter, you can't help.
Nice, Kent.
What? The rat. We gotta put a stop.
What do we do?
Emergency shutdown. My robots take control now.
Looks really bad. Okay, that guy's dead.
No. This can't be happening.
Oh, okay, he's dead.
No, Gwen, look at me! Gwen!
Alright, you let her
help with this thing. No! No!
Oh god. Oh, she's gonna become a rat woman. I don't know how I got that on it so fast. Were his hands putting things on the whole time? It's like a first-person game.
Help me!
What?
Gwen, are you okay?
I'll be fine, thanks. Get me to the quarantine area. I can help you save the other scientists from there.
jump high. Very high. Looking around for anything. I mean, there are 700. Whoa.
Look like they want to eat me for lunch.
They've been programmed to defend us against cross species, which I guess you technically are. So, yeah, watch out, Pete.
Why would you call me Pete? I'm Spiderman.
Oh my God, did you see that?
Don't worry, Gwen. Get you out of here.
It's not working. It got me.
Maybe you can web swing across.
What? Why did I get audio evidence? Because I watched that? Because I watched that chick says it's biting me? What? Anything down there? I also like her telling me I can web swing. Like I don't do it every day. The way he swings kind of reminds me of older games. It's pretty cool.
What if these Let's things get out of Oscorp?
I don't want to think about what ifs right now.
He auto vaults over things. It's weird. I can't think of a lot of games that do that. Yeah, the auto vault thing? Huh. I guess it's because the jump is so, like, you know, you jump so high in the air, so like no one's gonna be able to jump if it's this high. Just automatically make them vault.
More robots! Watch out!
You stay here.
Does every robot have to attack me?
Huh, interesting.
Hey Gwen, I'm a light packer. Time to get out of here.
Wow, that run animation though.
Pete, I need your help.
We need to find another way.
Right! Oscorp security system. Quarantine's on the other side. Stay here, Gwen. I'll come back to get you.
I feel like I can bring her, but alright.
Find a way to open the sealed door from the other side.
interact with what? Oh, it's probably... Yeah, okay, go. It just said it way too soon. Hello, okay, shiny girlfriend.
I'm getting you to safety.
Thanks, Pete.
I need to get the others before this really gets out of hand.
Pete, I think we both know that this is already out of hand. Dr. Smythe will have some answers. Find him.
I'll try, but Gwen, I have to ask. What's gonna happen? To you?
I don't know, but it's not going to be good. I'm infected, Pete. We all are. You remember what happened to Connors? This only leads to one thing.
But what about the antidote? If it worked before, then...
Connors was exposed to an earlier strain. You couldn't even call it a virus back then. It's evolved, mutated. There's no antidote to cure this.
What if I stop all the cross species?
There's no question they should be stopped, but even if they are, there's still a risk that the virus will spread.
Gwen, stay calm. I'm not gonna let anything happen to you, okay? We'll figure it out. I'll find Dr. Smythe and the others. Hopefully, it's not too late.
Wait, Peter. Take the Oz phone on the table.
The what?
It's the name of the Oscorp phone. It's still a prototype, but at least I'll be able to call you.
Okay. I'll get back as soon as I can.
My trusty Oz phone.
Whoa. Mr. Smythe, I presume. The one and only. Welcome to Oscorp, sir. I'm sorry Mr. Osborne couldn't join us today.
A shame, really. On such an important day.
How much do you know about what transpired here?
I know we can blame Kurt Connors for all of it. And I'm not surprised.
You know Dr. Connors personally?
Unfortunately. They say our brilliance as it pertains to our respective fields somewhat equals one another. Big difference being I have a conscience, and I lack a tail.
Thank you.
I like how these go off of one, so you get 1 point per level up, right? But then the tech thing over here goes off of, like, large increments. So again, the other one went off one. This goes off of, like, numbers, like money, right? So I have 80. It's like, why? Why are they both different? That's weird. Oh, that sounds cool. We'll wait for that.